Well, access to the arts is inequitably distributed in our society. Students from poor and less educated families are much more likely to record low levels of participation in the arts during the middle and high school years. Affluent youngsters are much more likely to show high rather than low engagement in the arts. The arts do matter, not only as worthwhile experiences in their own right, but also as instruments of cognitive growth and development and as agents of motivation for school success. In this light, unfair access to the arts for our children brings consequences of major importance to our society. Positive academic developments for children engaged in the arts are seen at every step of research, between 8th and 10th grade, as well as between 10th and 12th grade. The comparative gains for arts-involved youngsters generally become more pronounced over time. Moreover, and more important, those patterns also hold for children from low socioeconomic status. If you want to see other examples of students involved in the arts in Bay County schools, the Best of Bay Arts Show is an excellent opportunity. Also, Mosley High School Drama Department is presenting the Broadway musical Hairspray this weekend. The Broadway musical is a classic American contribution to field of music. Musicals combine singing, dancing, and dialogue to tell a story. Now, the musical Hairspray revolves around a self-proclaimed, pleasantly plump teenager, Tracy Turnblad, as she simultaneously pursues stardom as a dancer on a local TV show and rallies against racial segregation. Please enjoy You Can't Stop That Beat from Hairspray. Recent study conducted with colleagues at Harvard's Project Zero, an educational research group participating in a school arts program, increases a child's ability to observe the world carefully and discard preconceptions. Envision something and then create it. Go beyond just learning a skill to express a personal voice. Problem solve and persist despite frustration and setbacks. Reflect on the results and ask what could improve them. Freedom for All by Jerry Estes is an exuberant multicultural choral piece with a text featuring the word freedom in seven languages: Russian, Swahili, French, German, Hebrew, Spanish, and English. The singable melody is divided among all voice parts, and the harmonies are basic, easy to hear, and simple to learn. Smith, outgoing Florida Education Commissioner, the importance of the arts goes beyond just giving students a creative outlet. It provides students with a different way to think when they are adults. The world of our kids will be inhabiting will be more than numbers and reading. Creativity, abstract thinking, and coming up with ways to do things differently will be important in the coming decades for adults who want high-paying jobs. Smith said intensive reading is not a wildly successful initiative, and agreed that arts electives are important for student success. If our kids aren't innovators, they will be struggling in the years to come. The arts can be a part of that. Little people, dreamers, doers, earth shakers, movers, marvels, miracle makers. Sounds like innovators to me. These are the words to our next song, Dreamers. Hearing these children sing that song will make us all feel better about the future. Homegrown composer and Breakfast Point music teacher Gary Nichols wrote the anthem Dreamers to the aspirations of children everywhere. More than simply dreaming idly about the future, Dreamers speaks to the need to go out and work on your dreams, to make every day count, and to be movers and marvels and miracle makers. Mr. Nichols will provide the piano accompaniment for the debut performance of Dreamers.
We may be little people,
students of the arts continue to outperform their non-arts peers on the SAT. That's according to reports by the College Entrance Exam Board. In 2005, SAT takers with coursework experience in music performance scored 56 points higher on the verbal portion of the test and 39 points higher on the math portion than students with no coursework or experience in the arts. Scores for those with coursework and music appreciation were 60 points higher on the verbal and 39 points higher on the math portion. Researcher Barbara Helmrich of Baltimore's College of Notre Dame examined a sample of 6,029 ninth graders in six Maryland school districts. She found the students who studied music significantly outperformed their peers. While Helmrich notes the link between music interaction and algebra achievement most likely lies in the combination of factors, she agrees the primary effect is a matter of enhanced brain development. Middle school music instruction takes place during a time, which age 10 to 12, in which a proliferation of a new synapsis occurs in the developing brain. The study corroborates the opinion that these synapses are formed and strengthened, at least in part, by activities such as music. What better way to spread the desire for peace than through a song entitled A Song of Peace? Written by Teresa Jennings, A Song of Peace shares the story of a young child wishing she could write a song that would fill the world with peace. One song for all of us, a miracle, a song of peace. Springfield Elementary fifth grader Alexis Worley will be our featured soloist on this piece. Emma Lloyd from Oakland Terrace will share her dance interpretation of A Song of Peace, and students from Tyndall Elementary will interpret through signing. Without a doubt, music is the universal language. Doesn't get any better than that. Amen. We got a lot to be thankful for in this community. Before we bring the 31st Annual 5th Grade Elementary Music Festival to a close, we would once again like to thank those who donated and contributed time and money to keep this festival alive. Thank you to our superintendent and to our school board for believing in the importance of arts for all public education students. And thank you to the families of these students for your support of the arts in public schools. We ask that you remain in your seats at the end of the program to ensure the safety of your students. We will dismiss them by schools. We ask that you pick your children up in front of the stage, and again, please remain in your seats until your child's school is called. Well, we will end our program with a salute to our great nation, the United States of America. One Nation provides lyrics that are thought-provoking with music that alternates between haunting and passionate. The sequence that introduces the song is a summary of the whole idea: skin color, beliefs, age, address, social status, financial situation, race, etc. These are all beside the point. We are all Americans. We have a first tonight. Luke Whitlow from Petronas Elementary will be the piano accompanist for One Nation. And please remember to remain in your seats until your child's school is called. Our salute to America, One Nation.